Lockheed Martin delivered a record 191 F-35s in 2025, the highest annual output in the program's history, marking a major milestone for the Global Fighter Initiative. This followed the delivery of 110 aircraft in 2024, underscoring a sharp acceleration in production. The year also saw key international milestones. Finland celebrated the rollout of its first F-35, while Belgium received its first on home soil, expanding the aircraft's operational footprint across Europe. Production is now running at a pace 5 times faster than any other Western Allied fighter program, with nearly 1,300 F-35s sustained across the global fleet. Demand remains strong. In September, the F-35 Joint Program Office finalized lots 18 to 19, a $24 billion agreement covering the production of up to 296 aircraft, making it the largest procurement contract in the program's history. This record-setting year followed the program surpassing 1 million flight hours and completing its most advanced software upgrade to date, TR-3, which enhances combat capability and interoperability for both U.S. and international operators. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why F-35 program is turning out to be a major success story. Before we proceed, a word on NordVPN, which is one of the most trusted and fastest VPN brand that has a no-log policy validated by Deloitte. NordVPN provides a 256-bit encrypted tunnel that protects your privacy and also enables you to access contents that are blocked based on geolocation. Its threat protection system helps you avoid phishing, scams, and malware. NordVPN application is available for all the major platforms as well as browsers. Get an exclusive NordVPN deal with massive saving by going to nordvpn.com/defense or clicking the link in the description. It's risk-free with Nord's 30-day money-back guarantee. As of today, 20 countries have purchased or placed confirmed orders for the Lockheed Martin F-35. In practical terms, this means that, beyond the United States, 19 independent air forces have evaluated the aircraft and committed national budgets to it, a level of international endorsement unmatched by any modern fighter program. Combat simulations have consistently demonstrated the F-35's qualitative edge. During the 2016 Red Flag exercise, one of the world's largest and most demanding simulated air combat events, the F-35A reportedly achieved a 20-to-1 kill ratio against aggressor aircraft, which included F-15E and F-16 fighters, configured to replicate enemy tactics and capabilities. More recently, in late 2023, the aircraft underwent a series of Joint Simulation Environment, JSE, trials encompassing 64 high-fidelity combat scenarios. In these classified simulations, the F-35 was pitted against modern threat representative adversaries, widely understood to include advanced 4th- and 5th- generation platforms such as Russia's Su-35 and China's J-20. And yet, simulations alone are not the sole measure of the F-35's effectiveness. On October 26, 2024, Israel reportedly conducted a large-scale long-range strike operation involving more than 100 aircraft, including F-35 stealth fighters, against targets inside Iran. The mission required extensive aerial refueling to cover distances exceeding 1,600 kilometers, 1,000 miles. And struck more than 20 targets under an operation said to be named Days of Repentance. According to open-source reporting, Israeli aircraft were able to operate deep inside Iranian airspace, including over Tehran, without suffering losses, despite the presence of S-300 surface-to-air missile batteries. All participating aircraft reportedly returned safely. Notably, Iran was on heightened alert at the time, yet couldn't do anything. While official details remain classified and some claims remain unverified, multiple reports suggest that F-35s played a leading role in the operation, spearheading the attack and suppressing air defenses. Recently, in the early hours of January 3rd, the U.S. Marine Corps deployed F-35B fifth-generation fighter aircraft from forward bases in Puerto Rico to spearhead the air campaign launched against Venezuela. It reportedly cleared the airspace by knocking down S-300V and Buk M-2 with surface-to-air missiles, and went on to target Venezuelan air bases, destroying 7 fighters on the ground, including Su-30, Mark II, and F-16. F-35 in its baseline form has better avionics, much more holistic sensor fusion, stronger networking capabilities, and a meatier weapons package compared to any other fighter jet, probably apart from F-22 Raptor. But what will make it leap way ahead is the upgrades that will be received as part of Block 4 enhancements. A new computing core has been incorporated, which boasts a remarkable 25-fold increase in processing power compared to the current F-35. As per defense contractor L3Harris, this power boost will be combined with other enhancements to deliver an even more astonishing 37-fold increase in computing power in due course. The upgraded processor is expected to have a significant impact on a wide range of onboard systems, such as radar processing, electronic warfare suite, guidance, communications, and the distributed aperture system. In support of all this new power is a similarly impressive 20-fold increase in data storage. Currently, F-35s fly with the Northrop Grumman AN-APG-81 active electronically scanned array radar onboard, widely touted as the most powerful and capable radar system ever to fly in a tactical fighter. However, it is set to be superseded by an even more robust radar array called the AN-APG-85, which will likely use gallium nitride, GAN-based TRMS transmit-receive modules. The new radar has the potential to double the F-35's target detection range with the same power output and the same size array, giving the F-35 a distinctive edge against other fighters in beyond visual range engagements. The F-35's weapons payload will also expand significantly under the Block 4 upgrade, alongside the integration of several new munitions. Block 4 reportedly increases the aircraft's internal weapons carriage capacity. Current F-35 variants can carry a maximum of 4 internal weapons while preserving their low observable profile. Under Block 4, this number will rise to 6. To enable this, Lockheed Martin has developed a new internal weapons rack known as Sidekick, allowing the F-35A and F-35C to carry 2 additional air-to-air missiles internally without compromising stealth. In parallel, a range of new weapons is being integrated. These include the Joint Strike Missile, JSM, a long-range multi-role air-launched cruise missile, the AGM-88G, Advanced Anti-Radiation Guided Missile Extended Range, AARGM-ER, designed for standoff suppression and destruction of enemy air defenses, and the European Meteor air-to-air missile, widely regarded as one of the most capable beyond visual range BVR weapons in service. F-35's increasingly complicated onboard computers need more electric and cooling capabilities. In order to power all of these new systems, the F-35 will need an engine upgrade, which led to a battle between engine providers, General Electric, and the F-35's current engine producer, Pratt & Whitney. Pentagon opted for Pratt & Whitney's proposal, which the company calls an Evolutionary Engine Core Upgrade, ECU. This would increase the jet's existing F-135 engine's thrust by 10%, while improving fuel efficiency by 5%, resulting in what they claim is a 7% increase in range. The Pentagon launched the F-35 program in 2001 with the goal of creating an affordable next-generation aircraft to replace several aging U.S. platforms, including the F-15, F-16, FA-18, and the A-10. The jet was intended to become the backbone of American air power and a central component of Allied air forces worldwide. The program produced 3 variants: the F-35A conventional takeoff and landing model, the F-35B short takeoff and vertical landing version, and the carrier-capable F-35C designed for catapult launches and arrested recoveries. A lot was at stake. During the initial years, cost overruns and technical issues had cast a dark shadow on the F-35 program, but slowly, things are more or less falling into place. The unit cost of the F-35 has generally fallen over the years as production has ramped up and the program has moved into higher rate manufacturing, although prices fluctuate with production lots, inflation, engine costs, configuration changes, and contract terms. While near-peer rival like Russia and China are deploying their own fifth-gen fighter jets, they have a long way to go. Russia has only around 20 combat-capable Su-57s. Chinese have moved J-20 into serial production, but the aircraft is untested in combat and is still addressing challenges with crucial components like engines. Developing and deploying a fifth-generation fighter is incredibly difficult, which is why only a few countries are pursuing it on their own. The United States has again shown that it has the military-industrial complex to pull off this kind of stuff. F-35 program is delivering what it was supposed to, and this is bad news for adversaries.